edges polished through hard endeavor, jade shaped with meticulous fervor. Good morning, today is Monday, January 22, 2024. Today in history, on this day, 82 years ago, Xiao Hong, a prominent modern Chinese writer, passed away. Among her notable works are The Field of Life and Death, Abandoned Children, Mobile, and more. Xiao Hong departed from the conventional narrative modes of traditional novels, pioneering a marginal literary style that blends elements of novels, essays, and poetry. This distinctive style emerged from her unconventional language, autobiographical narrative method, non-linear plot structures, and poetic expression. Known for her unique Xiao Hongdi style, she earned the title of the literary goddess of the 1930s. Qing Qiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Qing Qiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. Dismissal of several senior Cambodian officials. Cambodian headline news, Kang Yuan, the former governor of KEP, Cambodia, has been arrested by the Cambodian Anti-Corruption Bureau on charges of abuse of power and money laundering. Prime Minister Hun Manet personally decreed his dismissal, emphasizing the government's commitment to punishing officials who seriously harm the interests of the people in accordance with the law. Additionally, the deputy director of the Anti-Narcotics Bureau of Cambodia's Thabunkman province was recently dismissed for corruption by the Ministry of Interior. Under Prime Minister Hun Manet's leadership since August last year, Cambodia has initiated an anti-corruption campaign. Last September, a deputy state secretary at the Cambodian Ministry of Justice was accused of fraud and irregularities, leading to his dismissal. In mid-October, the deputy director of a Cambodian anti-drug bureau and four subordinates faced authorities' action for suspected extortion. In December, the director of a Cambodian health bureau was dismissed for dereliction of duty. Furthermore, the deputy state secretary of the Ministry of Interior, accused of demanding a large sum of money from a company, was transferred to the Criminal Police Directorate for processing. Prime Minister Hun Manet has consistently emphasized the government's commitment to promoting and strengthening cleanliness in administration. Specific measures include formulating professional ethics and codes of conduct for public officials, enhancing the effective implementation of inspections and audits, bolstering public service management, enforcing strict law, cracking down severely on corruption, fostering collaboration between anti-corruption departments and various sectors, and promoting the integrity of public institutions. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. U.S. launches third attack on Houthi armed force. According to Agence France-Presse, the U.S. has recently conducted a new military strike against Houthi armed forces, destroying a ballistic missile they were preparing to launch. This marks the third such strike by the U.S. against the Houthi armed organization in Yemen since air and sea strikes were initiated by the U.S. and the U.K. White House spokesman Kirby stated that the U.S. does not aim to escalate the conflict, urging the Houthis to make the right choice and cease attacks on the Red Sea. On the same day, the Houthi armed forces launched several anti-ship ballistic missiles into the Red Sea, hitting the Maltese-flagged Greek bulk carrier Zografia. The vessel reported no injuries among the crew. Houthi spokesman Yahya Saria issued a statement, justifying the attack by claiming the ship was heading to the occupied Palestinian port. They emphasized their commitment to taking all measures to defend their legitimate rights in Yemen and expressed solidarity with the oppressed Palestinians. Israel and Hamas agree to provide aid to Gaza civilians and hostages. Recently, through mediation by Qatar and France, Israel and the Palestinian militant organization Hamas reached an agreement. Both parties agreed to provide emergency medicine to about 45 hostages held in the Gaza Strip, as well as offering humanitarian and medical assistance to the most vulnerable individuals in the Gaza Strip. Specific plans for assistance have not been disclosed by the relevant parties. Qatar mentioned that the list of aid supplies will be provided by Israel, purchased in France, and then transported by Qatar Air Force aircraft. The French side stated that negotiations have lasted for many weeks, and although three French hostages are still being held in the Gaza Strip, they do not require urgent medical treatment. According to agents France-Presse, the United States is very confident that the Israel-Hamas agreement brokered by Qatar and France will encourage a new round of hostage negotiations, believing that results can be achieved soon. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. Malaysia to review bilateral foreign worker agreements with 15 countries. According to Lien Hazaubao, the Malaysian Ministers of Human Resources and Home Affairs recently shared that authorities would review bilateral agreements on foreign workers with 15 countries. The objective is to address issues of exploitation and the uneven distribution of Malaysia's labor force. Over 70% of foreign workers in Malaysia originate from Indonesia, Bangladesh, and Nepal, with the remainder mainly coming from India, Vietnam, Pakistan, and Thailand. Since 2023, thousands of foreign workers have been left jobless after paying high recruitment fees to come to Malaysia. This situation has gained global attention, leading to a U.S. import ban on certain Malaysian products. The impact extends to Malaysia's planting industry, creating a significant labor shortage affecting rubber production. Home Affairs Minister Safuddin Nazushin Ismail has stated that the government will allow the transfer of foreign worker quotas across departments. Simultaneously, the ongoing review of foreign worker agreements will consider factors such as fees, costs, contract conditions, and the health of foreign workers. Vietnam's industrial land rents expected to increase by 3% to 9%. Recently, the industrial real estate market absorption area in Vietnam's northern region for 2023 is projected to hit a five-year peak, exceeding 800 hectares, marking a 37% year-on-year surge. The average occupancy rate stands at 81%, while warehouse rents remain steady at $4.60 per square meter, and factory rents average $4.80, reflecting a 3.9% increase from the previous year. Conversely, in the southern market, limited industrial land supply has led to a 32% decline in absorption area compared to 2022, totaling around 500 hectares with an average occupancy rate of 92%. Warehouse rents and factory rents have seen year-on-year increases of 4.7% for $60 per square meter and 2.3% for $90, respectively. Notably, beyond the realms of electronics, automobiles, and accessories, companies from high-tech sectors like electric vehicles, semiconductors, and green materials are increasingly eyeing the Vietnamese market. Industry experts anticipate a 3% to 9% rise in Vietnam's industrial land rents over the next 3 years. The northern region is forecasted to experience an average annual growth rate of 5% to 9%, while the southern region is expected to see 3% to 7%. Warehouse and factory rents are projected to increase modestly by 1% to 4%. Now, here is some important safety information. Tour bus rollover in Thailand injures 17 Chinese. Thai media reports a bus carrying Chinese tourists overturned in Danong District, Phuket Province. The bus, with 16 Chinese tourists, one Chinese national, a Thai tour guide, driver, and assistant, had a total of 20 people on board. The accident resulted in injuries to 17 Chinese and two Thai staff, two of whom sustained serious injuries. Upon arrival, local police and rescue teams found the overturned bus impacting traffic with a shattered front windshield. The accident occurred on a curved section of the road known for bus overturning incidents. Warning lights have been installed in this area to enhance the safety awareness of drivers. Initial investigations by local police suggest that the accident may be attributed to the vehicle's high speed, failure to decelerate approaching the accident site, and subsequent loss of control during the turn. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Luang Prabang, Laos, marks 28th anniversary as World Heritage City. As reported by the Vientiane Times, the Luang Prabang Provincial Government Office and Deputy Governor Boundluam Manavong held a press conference to announce the commencement of the 2024 Laos Tourism Year and celebrate the 28th anniversary of Luang Prabang Province as a World Heritage City. In preparation for these events, Luang Prabang Province has outlined a series of 9 programs and 41 activities scheduled from October 2023 to December 2024. The initiatives include cross-border inspections, cultural exchange programs, and theatrical performances to promote cultural understanding both domestically and internationally. Luang Prabang was designated a World Heritage Site by UNESCO on December 9, 1995, marking Laos' first World Cultural Heritage Site. Encompassing 800 hectares, it spans Luang Prabang City and Jomphet County, with 611 significant buildings, including 168 religious structures, listed as historical monuments. In 2023, Laos' traditional handmade fabrics Naga pattern is slated to be certified as an intangible cultural heritage. Financial newsletter. Brazil's 2023/2024 soybean production is down by 4 million tons to 157 million tons due to drought in key states Mato Grosso and Goiás. This has led to a reduced national soybean yield level, now at 3.44 tons/hectare, down from the previous forecast of 3.53 tons/hectare in December 2023. That's all for today's Xinjiang Morning News. Thank you for listening.